Hey guys, welcome or welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me today. Today you're not going to see my face, lucky you. What we're going to do today is change colours in Photoshop. One thing that I get asked all of the time is, how do you change colours in photos? How can you change green to autumn or fall colours? And this has been something that's come up on quite a few online one-to-ones recently in terms of how to alter the colours. So to give you guys the answer to that part of kind of the workflow, I'm going to cover that off on this picture today. So this is basically as it was shot out of the camera. This is a picture of Cara, who is a lovely little old border collie. All I have done is I've just done a cleanup. So I've just removed some of the little bits hanging about, which is what I would normally do. And then what I would tend to do is get my colours ready. So I know in this particular image that I want to basically change everything that is green to like autumn colour, like brown, so that I remove how many colours we've got going on in here. Now there is yellow, red, green on the log. There is green everywhere else. There is some yellow on her. She's like 4,000 colours for some reason. So she's got loads of magenta up here and then loads of green cast from whatever this was that was in front of the camera there. Who knows what that was, but clearly I had my head in a tree. So on this particular image, what we're going to do is a few specific steps and we're going to end up with a beautiful autumnal scene. The first step of this is to make sure you've done your cleanup and all sorts of other stuff, and then we need to set the white balance. Now you guys know from my other YouTube videos that I non-destructively edit, so I don't destructively edit my images, and therefore what I actually do is convert my main editing image to a smart object that packages the file inside a protective cover, for lack of a better word, and allows you to stack filters on top of it and go back and change them. So with that now converted to a smart object, visible by the little paper symbol thing there, then the next thing that we do is go up to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. And that opens essentially Lightroom in Photoshop, Adobe Camera Raw in Photoshop. So then I need to take a white balance. Now this dog is white and black and therefore it's quite straightforward. She should not be this shade of pink on her head. So what I would tend to do is just grab hold of the white balance adjuster on a black and white dog, find an area that should be middle grey. Now for us, that is going to be the top of the head where the light connects. So sometimes it's on the back, sometimes it's the top of the head. If you've got warm sunlight on one side and cool shade on the other, pick an area from the cool shade, because blue is a lot worse than orange, in most people's opinion, I think. So I'm going to basically pick a section of her head, which technically will put the white balance to being correct. Now that theoretically is the correct white balance, I don't wholeheartedly agree with that, but I mean, apparently that's right. So I was definitely in a tree. But I mean, technically that is supposedly the right colour. Maybe still magenta, but we will just have to handle that, I think, at a later date. So with your colour basically picked, then come down into the hue, saturation and luminance section here. And within the hues, what I want to try and do is equalise the yellows with the greens so that it just makes my adjustments easier. So I'm going to try and push the yellows towards green, which has worked perfectly. So let me undo that for you. If you look down here, can you see that there's like it goes from like warm orange to yellow to green. What I want is it to go from like orange to green. So to do that, if I pull my yellow towards green, what it does is it puts all of the yellow bits into the green colour channel. Now, yes, that does alter the colour of the dog. So if you had a golden Labrador, for example, you would be careful about pulling that over. To be fair, all it's changing is the colour cast, nothing else. So I'm okay with that. So I'm going to move that all the way over into the green section, which gives us basically a green picture now because of how much of this foreground was in. Then I'm going to go over to luminance and bring down the greens there. Not massively, just a bit, and then the same with the yellows. So that just calms things down a bit for me and will help when I change these to orange. Then within the saturation, I need to make sure that green and yellow are quite highly saturated so that I have more room to play with in terms of the pixels. So when you get to this point, you can then run your other adjustments, which for me is always a double radial within Adobe Camera Raw. One, working on the background there, and I do same things all the time. I feel like I'm really predictable. Maybe I am. I don't know. So I do basically the same things all the time. So I'm happy with that. And then I make a new radial, which you just have to do off to one side now on the new version of Photoshop. I just basically reset my correction settings, invert, and then I'm just going to lift up the exposure in that section and up the texture a little bit. You could also maybe lift the shadows a little bit to get some detail back. Then that looks strange, but we're all good. We click OK, and that puts our adjustments into this image. So as you can see, we now look green as heck, you know? Then, and this is the changing of the color section, what we're going to do is we're going to go for one of my normal methods, which is to add a new adjustment layer. That adjustment layer will be a hue saturation adjustment layer. And within the hue saturation adjustment layer, there is a hand icon. If you click the hand icon, that will give you an eyedropper. You want to pick the greenest of the green of the greens, like there. And then you want to, and this is quite important, push your saturation to 100. And now we look like we've got some form of bad illness, but that gives us a really clear look at the colours that we've got going on. So we've got some more yellowy colour, and then we've got darker greens. I'm fine with this, but if you grab hold of the middle of your little slider, you can move it from side to side and it will show you what colours are selected there. Now I'm deliberately going to go away from the colours that are on the log. And if you had like, I don't know, a yellow dog, then you would also come away from the yellow on the dog. But for now, I'm kind of okay with that. So basically what that's done is that's selected everything that's green. I then go up into hue and pull that to the left because that puts us in the warmer zone. And I want to find an orange, like so. With our orange selected, we need to just be careful not to go too far, but with a good orange going on, we then bring the saturation back down to zero, and just like that, we have technically changed the colours. Now, I personally also like to pull the lightness of that colour down and then play with the saturation to get to a stage that I'm happy with. I think that I need to split this maybe into two different ones because I'm quite happy with the colour of that apart from on the more yellowy areas. So I'm going to stop with this adjustment right now and I'm just going to overlay it with another one. So I'm going to do hue saturation, I'm going to use my little drippy dropper picker thing, click in an area of this very yellow, and now we can see a difference in the colour. So we've got orange, yellow, bit of green, yellow green over here, and moving over into orange in the coat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get hold of that and I'm going to try and isolate what I want to change. What I will do is I will break that down. So you can bring the edges in of this little slider tool here and essentially shrink your selection window. But I can get either more of the orange or more of the green. So I'm going to let some of those oranges slip through, maybe to there. And then I'm going to bring that over and make them orange. And then bring my saturation back. And that's just tackled the residual greens. So I'm hoping you guys can see that. So in terms of what I'm going to do next with this, I'm just going to pull that side out a little bit more. I'm going to put my saturation back up so that I can see, because I just want to have a little bit more in that selection. You can always tell when I'm concentrating because I go really quiet. So what I'm wanting to do is basically just fine tune where those are on my color spectrum. I might go back to my original one, which, by the way, if you go back to another one, if you click on the adjustment icon and then go up, you will have to find the color that was moved. So we moved green. So if we go into greens, that is our adjustment there. So we can then go and fine tune. So if I pull them slightly more, remember that your adjustments stack. So if I change something on this one, it also changes something on this one. So that's picking up the residual greens a little bit more now. And I'm probably going to want to go into the yellows on that one and potentially pull them more. And then what I think I'm going to do on this one actually is bring them down quite a lot. I just want to get to a stage that I'm happy with the colours involved. I think for me I'm going to desaturate this, but that's just because of this picture, you know? Okay, so let's see what our before and after is. I'd say that's a pretty major change right there. And at this stage you would then start to mask out your subject. So I'm hoping that you guys have all watched the masking video, how to mask hair, which is vital. Go ahead and look at that up linked above. So with those two adjustments done, then it's up to you to finish your image. You can style it however you want to style it. I hope that this has helped give you a bit of another option or a new technique that you might not have tried. There are other colour changing techniques available. I use other ones, but this one tends to work sort of the quickest, the easiest and the best in terms of changing full colours. Try this out, tag me in some of your results. I hope this has been helpful for you. If it has, please do let me know in the comment section below. Share this video with your friends. Come and find us on Instagram. And of course, if you haven't already, please do press the subscribe button. Click the bell icon because it will give you notifications every single time I upload a video. I upload every week and sometimes more than that if I feel like it and if I have time. So yeah, I'll see you again soon.